Hi, Rabbi Gershon. Yesterday, you were malavim me. Well, you umant to yourself that today, I would have to be malavim you. Rabbi Gershon was a man of humility. Rabbi Gershon was a man who, whenever something had to be done, everybody said, let Gershon do it. Let him do it. It's his, everybody. When we were children, we learned the Rashi, Hatel Aleim Sorchei Tzibor, Vahim Kolim Me'aleim. Nebuch. Communal responsibility is a tremendous strain, and Gershon Tannenbaum took it upon himself. Because the hour is short, I want to speak perhaps to the family of Rav Gershon. Rav Gershon used to always tell me to end on a positive note. How can you end on a positive note? Last night, when I was speaking at the meeting, the subject was extraordinary care. All of the pressure on the family when someone is hooked up to life support. And all of the shyness and all of the terrible things that can happen. The pressure, the guilt, the pressure on the Rabbanim to make decisions, the pressure on the family to make decisions. And I looked over and Rav Gershon was nodding like, yes, he knew very well. He knew very well. To his family, I just want to say that your husband, your father, was spared that horrible thing. He was spared it. He nodded his head as if to say, oi, loya leiva. And that's called Misa Benishita. And that's what he had. And that's the positive note that the Rabbanim Shalom said to him, Rav Gershon, look, Chazu Ben Ahuvi.
Feels the pain of the people who are going to cry for him, who's going to miss him so much.
Rosh Chodesh is not as man of his paidim. The reason it's not as man of his paidim is because it's a yontif. Yontif, you make no hesped, that's a halucha. But ken zan, since we linked with Davin today, zeman kakur l'cholde doison. So a yid that passes away, that's nifte in Rosh Chodesh, he is nifte after a kapora. And after kapora, it's not needed so much as paidim. I don't want to make a hesped. I just want to say something that everyone knows. A hesped usually is bringing out, explaining the oilam, the chashivas of the nifta, things that the oilam doesn't know. I'm not going to say that that's hesped. I'm just going to mention something which I feel everyone knows. We learned today, this week, we're learning in the parasha, V'osu li migdosh, v'shachanti b'soichem. HaKadosh Baruch Hu verlangt von Klal Yisrael, V'osu li migdosh, v'shachanti b'soichem. So let's teach the pasuk. V'osu li migdosh is the pe'ula, the work that Klal Yisrael is going to do.
In this repetition, Tzulangi Yoren, for certain hatovas, certain chasodim that they did for me and for my family. And I'm here at least to express my hakaras hatov at this time. And the there is, the Gemara tells us that Man derochem rabbanon havelin benin talmidei chachamim, that sometimes we can know a person from seeing the extension of the person, his children, his family, and his chasodim. As Harav Katz mentioned before, a very important point, that if one loves Talmidei Chachamim, and Harav Tannenbaum, we know it personally through our work in Igud, Harav Tannenbaum had a great love for every Talmud Chacham. And of course, he was zeiche to have sons, as we heard, who are genuine Talmidei Chachamim, that are continuing on. And part of it is no wonder we should also mention Rav Tannenbaum is an enekel from great people. He was one of his ancestors was a great goyin in Tassayrik. And he was also in the family of Hagoyin Rabbi Yonasan Steif. So he was a person who had great, very strong roots. And those roots extend through the work that he did, through the Hatovas. Torah is a Torah Shel Chesed. By him it was Mamish, like the Gemara says, it was Tchilasa Gmilas Chasadim, Vesefa Gmilas Chasadim. This was the Torah that was Rav Tannenbaum.
And absorb all the things he had to teach me. I thought I had much more time. It was decided that now we're going to have to continue without having you next to me.
Tati, Avi, my Rebbe Rabbi, I can't believe we're here so soon. We heard about Tati's Nektakrizaskanos, the Igud. We heard about as a father, from the Riket, to his children. We heard from my brother about my father, what can I add? We heard that he was an asking, that he was busy with the Igud Rabbanim, arranging all the Rosh Chodesh. We used to sit as family and watch him go from one day speaking at the Lubavitch event, and the next day at a Satan event, and the next day at some government official. He was never intimidated. He always knew what to say, how to connect to the person, to the Hasidisha, to the different sides, to the literature, to the government officials,